how can you sell social media or internal social media into the top management in a way that reinforces their power and reduces their constant fear? She just gives a bit of background here that she rolled out social media in her global company. She's learned that the vision of culture change is more a vision than reality.
Mm-hmm.
I heard she was not to introduce a new culture to the top management that they don't want, but how do you sell social media to them in a way that reinforces their power and reduces their constant fear?
I mean, I guess it goes back to that, the kind of the what does power mean inside of a network, and that the kind of the classic dichotomy again that's set up there about kind of coercion and that sort of violence and on the one side, and that kind of like production, meaning, and communications on the other side. You know, if you look at social intranets through purely kind of a communications lens, network communication technology, like social intranet and some of the consumer type design patterns that we see inside of them, is where many staff members go these days for their social lives as well too, right? Be it Facebook or even their professional lives and things like LinkedIn or Twitter or what have you. And so it's kind of, in some ways, the call could be one argument is, you know, go where the crowd is going, and also the rules of inclusion to kind of pull a page from Castells is that the people are out there doing things on networks which may not be owned by you and programmed by you and quote-unquote controlled by you in a position of power. And what would you prefer, you know, your couple thousand employees creating an ad hoc group on Facebook and having those conversations there, or would you prefer those conversations to be had in an environment where at least you could find out what's going on and see who's having them, you know, and hopefully kind of, you know, I mean, perhaps it's, again, a bit Machiavellian, but kind of co-opting or, you know, just listening, you know, listening and surveillance are two different things as well, too. But, you know, I think that's one of the kind of arguments is where would you prefer all of this activity to be happening, on a network in which you have some influence over, perhaps not control, or elsewhere, because it will happen, right? I mean, this is the same about how corporations are using Twitter, brands are being spoken about externally, and companies are being spoken about externally, whether you like it or not, all over the place. So, you know, you may as well have it in, you know, in some sort of place where you can watch, measure, influence, you know, respond to, or something like that.